Welcome to my show, Discover Feng Shui with Joey Yap. Feng Shui has been a passion for me for the last 15 years, and I'm very happy that I'm able to share with you this passion in the next few weeks. During the course of the next few weeks, I'm going to share with you secrets of the trade, how you can apply Feng Shui for your home, for your apartment, for your office, and even how to select land. There'll be a session on myth and truth every week where I'm going to debunk some of the most common superstitions that surround the practice of Feng Shui. Did you know that there's a difference between classical Feng Shui and New Age Feng Shui? Classical Feng Shui actually deals with how you use your environment. And there'll be a session on questions and answers where you can actually send me your emails, your questions, and I'll have them answered in the show. So, join me in the next few weeks and begin your journey into classical Feng Shui. Let me first start by introducing you to the practice of Feng Shui. You know that the definition of Feng Shui is different to everyone. People have a certain perception of Feng Shui the moment you talk about, hey, did you know what Feng Shui is? You know, sometimes people think that Feng Shui involves how they decorate the house, they think that it's how they paint their house, or some even talk about, oh, the items that they have in the house, do they have some taboo or some mystical things that will influence their Feng Shui? You see, different definition, different people have different ideas on what practice of Feng Shui is. So I think that it's very important that we first start off by defining what is Feng Shui. There are two types of Feng Shui that I actually practice out there. The first type is New Age Feng Shui, that's about 95% of the perception of the public. And classical Feng Shui, that is what Feng Shui is really done in these houses or estates or corporations and so forth. Now let me first tell you about New Age Feng Shui. Most of the time, New Age Feng Shui focuses on culture, beliefs, or how you should decorate your house, interior design and so forth. That most of the time people think that the items they have in their house, the colors that they paint their house, all this have something to do with their luck. Did you know that this is actually not what Feng Shui is about? You really don't have to turn your house into a Chinese restaurant if you want to practice Feng Shui, because classical Feng Shui actually deals with the natural environment, how Qi actually works, how Qi comes from the outside all the way into the inside of the house, and how you actually tap into the Qi inside the house. For example, which room you use, which direction that you tap yourself into, where you place your bed and so forth. It is very, very subtle. You really need not turn your house into a Chinese restaurant when you practice classical Feng Shui. Classical Feng Shui deals with four important factors. The first factor is the environment. You got to study how the environment influences your particular property. For example, you got a whole stretch of terrace houses. Each and every single one faces the same direction. Now, does all of them have the same type of good fortune or bad fortune? Obviously not, because different location, you have different access, different environmental features. In the next few weeks, you will learn something about that too. And the second important factor is about the house building, all right? The way your building, the way your office is structured, whether you have a